This is the story of a company born of innovation, founded by doing what others said couldn't be done, and grown over the years by never being satisfied with the status quo. In 1946, in Adrian, Michigan, two friends had an idea. Charlie Hickman and Al Goldsmith thought there was a better way to extrude aluminum, that they could make the extrusion process precise enough to get a finished product in one pass and eliminate costly post-processing steps.
Having better tolerance tubing. Before then, a lot of people would extrude a tube, a larger tube than they would need, and then they size it down with using another die to produce a better tolerance to it. We do it all out of the die, out of the press, and don't have subsequent sizing to it.
Aluminum extrusion is a process where solid aluminum is heated and pushed through a small mold or die to create tubing. It's an awful lot like, well,
if you think of the old Play-Doh machines.
Big Play-Doh press.
Play-Doh press when you were a little kid.
It's essentially just you're putting the Play-Doh in and extruding out the tube.
Al and Charlie went to their company with this radical idea, but they were turned away and told it simply couldn't be done. That it wasn't possible for the extrusion process to be that precise. So they quit.
Those guys said that can't be done. And Charlie now said, we think it can. So they went down the street and started their own company.
And they opened up shop right across the street.
Initially, they didn't even have the funds to prove their concept out.
For years, they had to bide their time and sit on their breakthrough idea. It took 10 years to build enough capital to buy their first extrusion press, the very reason they went out on their own. But soon after, they proved to themselves and the industry that their idea was possible, and by the late 1950s, they had mastered high-tolerance aluminum extrusion and began a long history of innovation that has kept Brazeway far ahead of their competitors. With all the new business built from their first of many groundbreaking innovations, it came time to expand Brazeway to other locations. One of their major clients was General Electric, so they headed south to be closer to their facilities.
And they found a small business called Bendit Corporation in Shelbyville, Indiana.
In 1957, Al and Charlie purchased the Bendit plant and expanded their manufacturing to Shelbyville, Indiana.
One of the things Brazeway was known for back in the 60s and 70s is they created a transition tube which allowed you to join copper to aluminum.
This seemingly simple component that transitions one metal to another transformed an industry, allowing Brazeway to convert a market dominated by copper to aluminum and position themselves as the leader. In the 1960s, Brazeway developed the dog bone style heat exchanger, which used a single serpentine tube rather than a series of individual tubes. These heat exchangers were cheaper, easier to make, and more leak resistant. This, along with a new manufacturing process called Verafin, allowed for Brazeway to further expand the use of aluminum heat exchangers and stay ahead of the market. 1964 saw the passing of Al Goldsmith, which is when Charlie took over as the sole owner of Brazeway. Under Charlie, Brazeway continued to innovate and break into new markets. In 1989, with continued growth, Brazeway opened their third location in Hopkinsville, Kentucky. In the early 1990s, Brazeway once again pushed the industry as they moved from round tube to square microchannel tube to revolutionize the air conditioning in automobiles and continue their dominant place as the market leader. In the late 90s, Brazeway looked back at one of their innovations from the 1960s and applied the dog bone and Verafin technologies to larger commercial cooling applications, once again breaking new ground and once again increasing their market share. The continued growth resulted in Brazeway opening another location in Monterrey, Mexico in the late 1990s. In the early 2000s, Brazeway once again looked to their past to innovate the future, and began applying the low-profile and more compact square microchannel tube used in automotive applications to stationary air conditioning. Brazeway's most recent innovation is the Eco 7 evaporator. During an industry-wide change in coolant that required a slightly smaller tube, the engineers at Brazeway noticed that with the reduction in size, the heat exchanger became more efficient. They ran with this idea, and through years of R&D, modeling, and testing, created the Eco 7 evaporator, which redefined heat exchanger design and produced 20 to 30% increased efficiency. Brazeway was not only founded on innovation, but on a philosophy of always innovating. Their company mantra is obsolete everything you do and never be satisfied with the status quo.
That mantra has been ingrained into the culture at Brazeway in that it's never time to settle. It's always, how do we make our products better for our customers?
Obsolete what we've done before and do it better, more efficiently, with more quality, with more productivity. And that is in Brazeway's DNA to continuously improve ourselves.
Don't get enamored with your latest solution because there's somebody else out there trying to one-up you. So if something's out there that's going to be better, you better be the one that brings it to the industry.
It has been over 70 years since that fateful day in 1946 when two friends didn't take no for an answer. Brazeway was born through innovation, grown through never being satisfied with the status quo, and will continue to push new ground for many years to come.